Hi friends, welcome to the channel, The Nurse. Here we are discussing about anatomy, image-based questions and answers with their explanations. If you are not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe. Question starts now. First question.
First question. Identify the green colored bone. Zygomatic bone, ethmoid bone, maxilla, temporal bone. Correct answer is zygomatic bone. Zygomatic bone are two facial bones that form the cheeks and the lateral walls of the orbits. Each zygomatic bone articulates with the temporal bone, frontal bone, maxilla and sphenoid bone. Next question. Which of the following aneurysm mentioned in picture? AIIIMS aneurysm, PCOM aneurysm, medullary aneurysm, ruptured aneurysm. Correct answer is AIIIMS aneurysm. Anterior communicating aneurysm, artery aneurysm, is also known as AIIIMS aneurysm. Aneurysms of the anterior communicating artery are the most common circle of Willis aneurysms and can cause visual field defects such as bitemporal heteronymous hemianopsia due to compression of the optic chiasm, psychopathology and frontal lobe pathology. Next question. Which type of gait demonstrated here? Parkinsonian gait, coriform gait, ataxic gait, sensory gait. Correct answer is Parkinsonian gait. Parkinsonian gait or fascinating gait. Parkinsonian gait is characterized by small shuffling steps and a general slowness of movement, or even the total loss of movement in the extreme cases. It is seen in Parkinsonism due to deficiency of dopamine. Next question. Which gland marked pink in color? Pituitary gland, thyroid gland, adrenal gland, prostate gland. Correct answer is adrenal gland. Adrenal glands or suprarenal glands, it is located above the each kidney. It has outer cortex which produces steroid hormones such as cortisol, and has inner medulla which produces adrenaline and noradrenaline. Next question. Identify the red marked area. Sacral promontory, anterior superior iliac spine, greater trochanter, acetabulum. Correct answer is anterior superior iliac spine. Anterior superior iliac spine. It is a bony projection of iliac bone. It refers to the anterior extremity of the iliac rest of the pelvis, which provides attachment for the inguinal ligament and the sartorius muscle. Next question. What is the term used to indicate the area marked in red triangle? Wrist box, anatomical snuff box, carpal tunnel, anterior cubital fossa. Correct answer is anatomical snuff box. Anatomical snuff box. The anatomical snuff box or snuff box is a triangular deepening on the radial dorsal aspect of the hand at the level of the carpal bones, specifically the scaphoid and trapezium bones forming the floor. Next question. Which type of uterus shown in picture? Gynecological uterus, bicornuate uterus, arcuate uterus, septate uterus. Correct answer is bicornuate uterus. Abnormal uterus types. Septate uterus, a normal external uterine surface but two endometrial cavities. In bicornuate uterus, an abnormal indented external uterine surface and two endometrial cavities. In arcuate uterus, a normal external uterine surface with a 1 cm or less indentation into the endometrial cavity. Next question. Which area located in between eyebrows marked green in green here? Forehead, glabella, anterior fontanelle, vertex. Correct answer is glabella. Next question. Identify the abdominal region is question marked here. Hypogastric region, left lumbar region, umbilical region, epigastric region. Correct answer is hypogastric region. Next question. Which articular surface of upper body marked red in color? Acetabulum, glenoid cavity, medial condyle, ala of the sacrum. Correct answer is glenoid cavity. Glenoid cavity or glenoid fossa of scapula is a part of the shoulder. It is a shallow piriform articular surface which is located on the lateral angle of the scapula. It articulates with the head of the humerus and form shoulder joints. Next question. Which area pointed with thumb here? Glabella, Adam's apple, jugular notch, carotid pulse. Correct answer is jugular notch. Jugular notch, the suprasternal notch, also known as the fossa jugularis sternalis or jugular notch, is a large visible dip in between the neck and two collarbones of the human anatomy. Next question. Which area marked red in color? Angle of Lewis, manubrium, siphe, head of the clavicle. Correct answer is manubrium. Next question. Identify the abnormal communication marked circle here. VSD or Wendel septal defect, AST atrial septal defect, PDA patent ductus arteriosus, tetralogy of Fallot. Correct answer is PDA or patent ductus arteriosus. Patent ductus arteriosus is a condition wherein the ductus arteriosus fails to close after birth. Early symptoms are uncommon, but in the first year of life include increased work of breathing and poor weight gain. Next question. Identify the red colored muscle helping in the movement. Trapezius, pectoralis major, linea alba, soleus. Correct answer is pectoralis major. The pectoralis major is a thick fan-shaped muscle situated at the chest of the human body. The pectoralis major muscle has three parts: clavicular parts, sternocostal part, abdominal part. Action: abduction and antiversion of the shoulder, medial rotation of the arm, retroversion of the arm. Next question: which pulse is palpating here? Popliteal, dorsalis pedis, foot pulse, posterior tibial. Correct answer is posterior tibial. Next question: identify the muscle highlighted red in color. Trapezius, sternocleidomastoid muscle, temporalis muscle, rectus capitis posterior major. Correct answer is rectus capitis posterior major. Rectus capitis posterior major origin. It originates from the spinous process of the axis, that is second cervical vertebrae. Insertion: the rectus capitis posterior major inserts into the inferior knuckle line on the external surface of the occipital bone. Action: the main movements provided by the rectus capitis posterior major are ipsilateral rotation of the head and extension of the head. Next question: identify the part circled here. Parotid gland, uvula, vocal cord, frenulum. Correct answer is uvula. The uvula is made up of mucous membranes, connective and muscle tissue, as well as canals that excrete saliva. It is very flexible, which ensures that it can fulfill its functions, such as production of saliva, obstructing nasopharynx while swallowing, etc. The question ends here. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe this channel, Dinners. Thank you. Have a nice day.